Today I'm going to discuss the most important poem is Amarkanti by the Narendranath Chakravarti. The poem Amarkanti has been written by the famous Bengali poet Narendranath Chakravarti. It has been published in Oxford Anthology of Modern Indian Poetry, New Delhi, 1994. The poem is originally written in the Bengali language but has been translated into English by Sujit Mukherjee and Meenakshi Mukherjee. Narendranath Chakravarti is a Sahitya Academy Award winner and has written various famous books like the Ulanga Raja. Apart from this, he has also been awarded a Doctor of Science degree. So, in this paragraph, he comes to know that how the Amarkanti was a famous Bengali poet Narendranath Chakravarti, and it has been published in Oxford Anthology of Modern Indian Poetry, New Delhi, 1984. The poem is originally written in the Bengali language but has been translated into English by Sujit Mukherjee and Meenakshi Mukherjee. Narendranath Chakravarti is a Sahitya Academy Award winner and has written various famous books like the Ulanga Raja. Apart from this, he has also been awarded a Doctor of Science degree. The term Amarkanti means a pure radiance. In the poem, Amarkanti is the name of the main. Amarkanti's name suits his character very well, as he wants to become the sunlight. So Amarkanti wants to become a sunlight, that's why his name is very suitable for him. Which refers to the source of the Narendranath Chakravarti has used the literary devices. He has used irony to express whether Amarkanti is successful in becoming sunlight or not. Irony is the device or the statement in which the meaning to that the speaker implies differs strongly from the meaning that he expressed visibly. So the term Amarkanti means a pure radiance. In the poem, Amarkanti is the name of the main. Amarkanti name suits his character very well, as he wants to become the sunlight, which refers to a source of the Narendranath Chakravarti and has used the literary devices. He has used irony to express whether the Amarkanti is successful in becoming sunlight or not. Irony is the devices or the statement in which the meaning to that the speaker implies differs strongly from the meaning that he expressed visibly. So, यहाँ पे जो irony meaning है devices का कि जो speaker ने use किया है poem में the statement is very opposite to the real meaning. So, the meaning to the speaker implies differs strongly from the meaning that he expressed visibly. So, it is called irony. In the next paragraph, he comes to note that in the poem, the speaker says that Amarkanti is his childhood friend. He was Amarkanti was a weak student and not bright in studies. And he often came to school late and never completed his class lessons. When he asked to conjugate a verb, he could not able to complete his tasks and stood speechlessly. This is maybe because he never listened to his class lesson, was always gazing out of the windows. The poet further says that his whole class felt sorry for him. In the poem, the speaker says that the speaker जो है वो ये कहता है कि Amarkanti is his childhood friend. He was in his same Amarkanti's was a weak student and not bright in studies. He often came to the school late, never completed his class lessons. When asked to conjugate a verb, he could not able to complete his tasks and stood speechlessly. This is maybe because he never listened to his class lessons and was always gazing out of the windows. हमेशा वो क्लास में कभी भी कॉन्सेंट्रेट नहीं करते थे, हमेशा खिड़की से बाहर ही देखते रहते थे. That's why he is a weak student and he is not able to conjugate any kind of verb. The poem further says that his whole class felt sorry for him. The poet is explaining everyone ambitious and how focused they were achieved them. Some of them wanted to be a teacher, some of them wanted to be a doctor, lawyer, etc. But Amarkanti did not want it to be those. His goal was to become the sunlight, that even the light of the setting the sun's dusk is responsible for the fresh beginning of summer. He wanted to be that sunlight that brings the smile on the faces of the jamru leaves after heavy rains. He wanted to be sunlight which will act for others as the source of the inspiration. So the poet is explaining everyone ambitious and how focused they were achieved them. Some of them kuch log doctor banna chahte hain, kuch log teacher banna chahte hain, but Amal Kanti wants to be a sunlight. So this kind of ambitions he has, and he becomes a sunlight, and that even the light of the setting the sun dusk is responsible for the fresh beginning of the summer. So sun is responsible for the fresh beginning of the summer. He wanted to be the sunlight that bring the smile on the faces of the jamru leaves after heavy rains. So that's why he wants to be a sunlight. He wants to give the pupils smiley faces, and after the heavy rains, he wanted to be a sunlight which will act for the other as source of inspiration. He want to be an inspiration for the others. That's why he wants to be a sunlight. So there is a irony device which he has used by the poet. In the poem, he has hidden great irony without which it is possible to understand the poem. Amal Kanti becomes the worker of printing press and works in a dark room. According to the speaker, he could not become the source of inspiration. But the speaker is not noticing the fact that becoming a worker of press, Amal Kanti has become the sunlight that he always wanted to become by publishing books that have always inspired people and always will. So in the poem, he has written great irony without which it is impossible to understand the poem. So yahan pe irony hai, yahan pe use kiya hai by the poet, which is totally opposite to the real meaning. And Amal Kanti becomes a worker of printing press and works in a dark room. According to the speaker, he could not become the source of inspiration. But the speaker and not notice the fact that becoming a worker of press, Amal Kanti has become the sunlight that he always wanted to become by publishing both that has always inspired people and always will. So now he becomes a source of inspiration by working in the printing press. That's why he becomes the inspiration for the other. He is working in a dark room in the printing press, but he becomes the inspiration in the indirect way as he publishing books which inspire the people. That's why the meaning is irony in the poem. Our real world is driven by the ambition and dreams, but greed is the power that has overcome them. The idea of becoming sunlight is unrealistic in real world, but as becoming the source of inspiration, it is not everyone in this world inspired by some, but some from singers, retired writer, so some from their parents. Although most of the people do not intentionally want to become that inspiration, but end up becoming one. For example, a singer doesn't want to become the inspiration for someone, but he unknowingly inspires many people. In this way, the idea of becoming the sunlight is not foolish, and up to some point is also not unrealistic. So our real world is driven by the ambitious. In our real world, ambitions se hi jo hamari duniya hai wo chalti hai in dreams, but greed is power of is the power that has been overcome them. So everybody wanna have a greed to become someone like doctor, teacher, lawyer, and a political leader as well. As so everybody have the ambitions to become, and everybody has the desire and greediness to become someone. The idea of becoming sunlight is unrealistic in the real world, but as becoming a source of inspiration. So by the poem, we come to know that how the sunlight, how to become a sunlight is unrealistic in the real world because everybody wants to become a someone. Nobody wants to become a inspiration for someone, but in an indirect way, they become an inspiration. That's why to become a sunlight is also a great desire and inspire everyone. It is not everyone in this world inspired by someone, and some from singer writer, so some from their peers. Although most of the people do not intentionally want to become that inspiration but end up becoming one. For example, a singer doesn't want to become inspiration for someone. एक सिंगर भी कभी किसी की इंस्पिरेशन नहीं बनना चाहता बट बाय देयर सॉन्ग्स दे बिकम एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर द अदर एंड इंस्पायर एवरीवन इन दिस वे द आइडिया ऑफ बिकमिंग सनलाइट इज नॉट अ फुलिश एंड अप टू सम पॉइंट इज ऑल्सो नॉट रियलिस्टिक सम पॉइंट भी ऑल्सो नॉट अ अनरियलिस्टिक थिंग सो द कंक्लूजन ऑफ दिस पोयम इज दैट नरेंद्र चक्रवर्ती सेड दैट द पीपल हु वॉन्ट्स टू बिकम द टीचर कुड हैव ईजली बिकम द डॉक्टर द डॉक्टर कुड हैव बिकम द लॉयर इफ दे हैड दैन इट रियली वुड नॉट हैव मैटर दैट मच दे ऑल गॉट वॉट दे वॉन्ट बट सम मोर और सम लेस बट अमल कांति इज ओनली द हु कुड नॉट बिकम द सनलाइट दैट ही ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड टू बी So, in the indirect sense, Amal Kanti wants to become the sunlight, but he could not able to become one. But in the by working in the dark room in the printing press, he inspired the many pupils by their books. So, in the indirect way, he wants to he becomes the inspiration for the other. So, by this poem, he comes to know that how the Amal Kanti becomes the inspiration for the other by working the painting plans and how his ambition is also are realistic is not a unrealistic thing and poet have used irony meaning here so the what is the actual meaning is it totally opposite what is visibility so now we have the some question answer for this poem is Amal Kanti desire to become the sunlight is unrealistic or foolish except by providing the example in your answer So, by the structure of the answer, we comes to know that how should we write answer. So, first of all, you have to write the introduction of the Amal Kanti. Amal Kanti and Narendra Chakraborty and how he has published in Oxford Anthology of Modern Indian poetry in Delhi 1994. The poem is originally written in Bengali language but has been translated into English by Sujit Mukherjee and Meenakshi Mukherjee. Narendranath Chakraborty is a Sahitya Academy awarded winner and has written various famous books and like the Ulanga Raja. Apart from this, he has also been awarded a Doctor of Science degree. He comes to know that how the poem Amal Kanti has been written by the famous Bengali poet Narendranath Chakraborty and it has been published in Oxford Anthology of the Modern Indian Poetry, New Delhi, 1994. So, by this paragraph, he comes to know that the whole history of the Narendranath Chakraborty and how he has written Amal Kanti poem, which is very beautifully written and has an irony meaning. The term Amal Kanti means pure the radiance. In the poem, Amal Kanti, the name of the main Amal Kanti name suits his character as very well as he wants to become the sunlight. Radiance means when we see the sun, there is a radiance in the light. There is a lining in the sunlight. That's why. Which refers to the source of the Narendra Chakraborty has used the literary devices. So, which jo refer karta hai jo sources hai Narendra Chakraborty ke ki unhone used kya literary devices ko. He has used the irony to express. Ne irony express kiya hai whether Amal Kanti is successful in becoming the sunlight or not. Irony is the devices or the statement in which the meaning to that the speaker implies differs strongly from the meaning that he expressed visibility. So, irony, जो ट्रम यूज हुई है, लिटरेरी डिवाइसेज यूज हुई है, वो अमरकांती पोएम में बहुत ही ज़्यादा सुटेबल है, बिकॉज द अमरकांती वॉन्ट्स टू बी हैव सनलाइट एंड इंस्पायर द अदर, बट ही इज़ नॉट एबल टू बिकम अ सनलाइट बिकॉज इट इज़ द बिकॉज इट इज़ द हिज एम्बिशियस कंसिडर एज अनरियलिस्टिक इन द रियल वर्ल्ड, बट इन डायरेक्ट वे ही बिकम द सनलाइट एज ही वर्किंग इन द प्रिंटिंग प्रेस एंड इन द डार्क रूम एंड पब्लिश द बुक्स एंड विच इज़ द सोर्स ऑफ द इंस्पिरेशंस फॉर द पीपल्स. सो इन द डायरेक्ट इन द इनडायरेक्ट सेंस ही बिकम्स द इंस्पिरेशन फॉर द अदर्स. सो दैट्स वाई ही डिफर द मीनिंग इज डिफर स्ट्रांगली फ्रॉम द मीनिंग इज एक्सप्रेस विजिबिलिटी. In the poem, the speaker says that Amarkanti is his childhood friend. So, जो speaker है वो ये कहता है कि Amarkanti जो है उसका childhood friend है. He was in his same Amarkanti was a weak student or not bright in studies. वो एक student था और थे और वो study में बिल्कुल भी अच्छे नहीं थे. And he often came to school late or never completed his class lessons. And when he asked to conjugate a word, he could not be able to complete his task, stood speechlessly. When teacher asked to conjugate a verb, he stood speechlessly as he always missing his class lesson and always comes late since school. He was a very weak student in the class. That's why he is not able to conjugate a verb. And stood speechlessly. This is maybe because he never listened to his class lessons and was always gazing out of the window. Always gazing out of the windows, मतलब वो हमेशा विंडो से बाहर ही देखते रहते थे और कॉन्सेंट्रेट नहीं करते थे अपने क्लास लेसन्स में. द पोएट फर्दर सेज दैट हिज होल क्लास फेल्ट सॉरी फॉर हिम. पूरी क्लास जो थी वो बहुत सॉरी फील करती थी उनके लिए कि हाँ मतलब वाई ही इज़ नॉट एबल टू डू एनी थिंग एंड वाई ही इज़ नॉट एबल टू कंजीक्यूट अ वर्क एंड स्टूड स्पीचलेसली. द पोएट एक्सप्लेनिंग एवरी वन एम्बिशंस एंड हाउ फोकस दे वर अचीव देम. सम ऑफ देम वॉन्टेड टू बी टीचर, सम ऑफ देम वॉन्टेड टू बी डॉक्टर, लॉयर एक्सेट्रा, बट अमरकांती डिड नॉट वॉन्टेड टू बी दोज. हिज गोल वॉज टू बी बिकम द सनलाइट, दैट इवन द सनलाइट light up the setting, the sun task, sun dusk, and is responsible for the fresh meaning of the summer. The way sun dusk, sun ki jo rays hoti hai wo summer mein ek new beginning ko bhi matlab starting hoti hai, in the fresh meaning of the summer. In the same way, he wants to be a sunlight. He wants to be a source of the beginning for the freshness and the beginning of the summer. And he wants to be that the sunlight that brings a smile on the faces of the jungle leaves. So, he wants to become the sunlight and gives the smiley faces of the jungle leaves. And after heavy rains, मतलब जब बहुत बारिश हो जाती है उसके बाद जो एक हल्की सी धूप निकलती है उससे सबके फेस पे स्माइल आती है. एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू बी दैट दिस काइंड ऑफ अ सनलाइट. सो ही वॉन्ट्स टू बी अ सनलाइट विच विल एक्ट फॉर द अदर्स एज सोर्स ऑफ इंस्पिरेशन. ही वॉन्ट्स टू बी अ इंस्पिरेशन फॉर द अदर. आयरनी, सो द आयरनी टर्म इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन द पोएम एंड विच हैव अ differ meaning which is visible in the poem's lines. So in the poem is hidden great irony without which is it is not possible to understand the poem. Amarkanti becomes the work of printing press and works in a dark room, and according to the speaker he could not become the source of inspiration. But the speaker is noticing in the fact that by becoming a worker of press, Amarkanti has become the sunlight, and that he always wanted to be become by publishing book that has always inspired people and always will. So by working in the printing press, he becomes the inspiration of the other because he published the book, and the books inspired the other pupils. So he becomes a source of inspiration, as he wants to become a source of inspiration of the other to become a sunlight. Our real world is driven by the ambitious and the dream, but greed is a power that has overcome. The idea of becoming a sunlight is unrealistic in the real world, but has become the source of inspiration. So it is not everyone in this world inspired by someone, but from the singer writers, also some from their parents. So everybody inspired by everyone. Some people inspired by the singer, some people inspired by the teacher. Everyone becomes a source of the inspiration, and by working in the printing press, Amal Kanti also becomes a source of inspiration as he published books in the printing press, and he also becomes a source of inspiration. So for example, a singer doesn't want to become an inspiration for the someone, but still he unknowingly inspired many pupils. In the same manner, Amal Kanti also become a sunlight for the others and inspiration for the other. In the same way, the idea of becoming sunlight is not foolish, and up to some point is also not unrealistic. So the conclusion of the poem. Nindana Chakrabarti says that the poem who wants to become the teacher could have easily become the doctor. The doctor could have become the lawyer. If they had, then it really would not have mattered them much. They all got what they want, some more or some less. But Amal Kanti is the only who could not become the sunlight that he always wanted to be. So, by the conclusion, we come to know that how the meaning of the poem is very irony. And Nirendranath Chakrabarti says that a pupil who wants to become the teacher could have easily become the doctor. So, doctor could have become a lawyer. So, everybody have a desire to want to be someone and inspire the other. And by the poem science, we come to know that everyone become someone. In the same manner, Amal Kanti is also become the someone who inspired the other pupils. What do you think is a speaker attitude towards the Amal Kanti? So, स्पीकर का जो एटीट्यूड है अमल कांति की तरफ, वो किस तरीके से है? बाय द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द आंसर वी कम्स टू नो दैट हाउ द एटीट्यूड ऑफ द अमल कांति द स्पीकर्स एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड द अमल कांति एंड वी हैव टू राइट द सेम स्ट्रक्चर इन द आंसर एज यू वांट टू गेन द मैक्सिमम मार्क्स इन योर एग्जामिनेशन. You have to write the each and every paragraph, which is very important, and you have to write in the same structure. First of all, you have to write the Amal Kanti introduction and the Nirendranath Chakrabarti introduction, and the term and the meaning of the Amal Kanti names, and how he wants to become a sunlight and inspiration for the others, and how his school life and how is managing all the things, and Nirendranath Chakrabarti has used the literary devices of the irony. In the irony means that the meaning is different from which is expressed in the line. So that's why he has used the irony meaning, and you have to write the irony meaning and how the irony meaning visible in the poem. You have to explain, and in the poem, the speaker says that Amal Kanti is his childhood friend, and how his school life is going. You have to explain all the things, which is very important. You can't skip each and every paragraph, because the explanation is very important, and you have to explain all the things. The poet is explaining everyone's ambitions and how focused they were achieved them. So now you have to write this paragraph also, how the poet is discussing the ambitions of the other and how they become someone and inspire the other people. So irony devices also here. You have to explain how the irony meaning is coming in the poem line, and Amal Gandhi has become the satellite that he has always wanted to be by publishing, that have always inspired people and always will. So how the meaning is, how his ambitions to become a satellite is unrealistic in the real world, you have to explain this paragraph also. And the conclusion is very important. You have to write in your own language, and by the poem's line. And you so I hope you like this video, which is very important for your examination point of view. Thank you so much.